I'm Michael Alexander, and I've to tell you something about the origin of my book, Making Peace with the Universe. It came from standing in front of classrooms for many years teaching religious studies and finding myself having to explain to intelligent young students just how often religion is just the crassest, used as the crassest justification for racism and sexism and sexual phobia and nationalism. And I find myself in mid-career sort of thinking, why is there any value in this really? And how can I move forward when I'm not really dedicated to just the explanation of religion along those lines to young people? And I sort of had a crisis of career in thinking about that. And I also was in midlife and was looking for some therapy, and I had spiritual curiosities that I'd always wanted to itch, but for some reason felt that I had to put them in brackets because I'd become professional analyst of religion. And so I decided to say the heck with it. I want to turn to some of the sources that brought me into the curiosities that brought me to want to study these things in the first place. And I was really liberated in the project to move forward definitively when I realized that as I was perusing old confessions, how many of them had been composed by somebody who had been in almost identical circumstances, somebody who had suffered a personal crisis, a real freak out, or a professional crisis, or was going through an addiction or some kind of a bodily demise, just terrible things that, of course, that life heaps on all of us, and that they had come to a place where they had did not know the way forward and therefore gave themselves over to their spiritual curiosity in order to move forward. And because religion at the time in which they lived had been the location where one would try to get some orientation, they did so and successfully. And because they were geniuses, they were able to write it down and to share it with us and to share it with their own traditions about and these became part of the canons of those traditions. And so I wanted to look at spiritual these I wanted to look at I realized that spirit that religion had been the forum for therapy before there was modern therapy, and that I wanted to sort of see if they had done things spiritual therapy was done differently from how it is therapy is practiced today. So I had all that's essentially what the book is about. So I that there's that aspect of it. And then there was a second aspect, which I think is to me it's equally important, which is that I realized that it had been spiritual curiosity that had pushed these people to finally start to explore things that previously, being reasonable adults and typically in fairly decent careers, they had thought to be juvenile or adolescent curiosities that were not worthy of adult attention. So it was only coming to the end of their rope, as it were, that they decided to say, the heck with it, I'm actually going to go look at those things seriously. And they did. So I did feel that I wanted to give something about of the spirit of spiritual adventure. I wanted to capture that because all the confessions capture that as well. And because that had given me my own permission to sort of move forward and ask these questions, these juvenile adolescent questions seriously, I wanted to capture some of that for the reader as well. And so that I do hope is reflected in my discussions of those great confessions. And that essentially became Making Peace with the Universe.